mpoko a malamu epai na bandeko bazuli bako ya kolanda biso mpoko ya lelo. Nzambe azamala.
God is good.
Nzambe abongi na nkem.
God is worthy of the praise.
Nzambe abongi na masanzoli.
God is worthy of the worship.
Soki toza oyo toza lelo eza mosala ya maboko ya Nzambe na bomo.
If we are who we are today is by the works of the hands of the living God.
Zambi kozala na bomoi ezali kabona nzambi.
For being alive on its own is a gift by God.
Ezala ke for ya moto te.
It's not by the effort of a man.
Me tozako vivre pona me puissante ya nzambi.
But we are living because of the powerful hand of God.
Ebele balamukaki.
Many woke up.
Lelo bazala bomoi te.
Today they are no longer living. Many crossed the roads that you and I crossed. But they have realized that they're not even living. But if you and I are here today, it's by the love of God. May the Lord be glorified. For he is worthy of it. There is no other like him. And no one else can take his glory. Let the praise and worship go back into his kingdom. Tell your family member that it's now time. We are sitting today because we have gone back to the school of faith. Yes, the Lord has sent us to go back to the school of faith. To show all those that believe in God how they should really be walking with their God. Call a family member. Call a mother. Call a friend. And tell them it's now time to be blessed. We want to take on knowledge. This is the fourth point which we have now entered. Let's give the announcement. The first announcement is that we have a night vigil on the 28th.
No, le 28, pardon.
On the 28th.
Le 5, qui était, mais le 28.
Not the 5th, but the 28th, on Friday.
Vendredi, apostle.
On Friday. Please forgive me because I had planned to first of all speak of the youth meeting. And the 5th has now been stuck onto my
head. 28 vendredi tozana veillée de prière.
On the 28th we have the night vigil.
Oui.
Yes.
Vendredi.
On Friday.
De 22h à 5h du matin.
From 10 p.m. to 5 a.m.
Zambi tozwa mokano ya kotele mabutu moko liboso na Nzambe kobondela.
For we had taken on the decision to stand up at least one night in front of God to pray.
Olali ntango molai.
You slept for a very long time.
Yaka koka mabutu moko na maboko ya Nzambe.
Come and at least share this night with us in front of God.
Nzambe akosalela yo bolan.
And the Lord will do gracious things for you.
Tozana renyo ya bana.
We do have a youth meeting.
Le 5.
On the 5th of November.
November, samedi de 14h à 18h.
It's a Saturday from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m.
Tinda bana na yo ba ye kola lilo bana nzambe.
Send your children so that they can learn the word of God.
Makambo yo koki kosala tem lilo ba akosala yango pona bolamu na yo.
Well, you yourself are not able to do the word, we'll do it for your goodness.
Oui, le 5 novembre za renyo.
On the 5th of November, that's all the youth meeting. On Friday is the night vigil. We are moving from the hall that we do our service.
Wood Green to Zakoya na Tottenham.
We're moving from Wood Green to Tottenham.
Kubanga tena suka emisio bakotia publicity okoyebe sikani ni saleza.
Don't worry, at the end of the show they're going to put on an advert for you to tell you exactly where the hall is.
Le 6 to bandi priere sikawa.
On the 6th we begin our service.
Donc début à moi premier dimanche à mois de novembre.
So the first Sunday of November.
Oui, yangonde esengeli oyeba.
That's what you needed to know. We'll no longer be in Wood Green. The Lord has given us a great place. In the meantime, we are out looking for a leasehold and we'll see how the Lord helps us. For the money that the children of God had given is still there. We have not taken any of it. We are always reporting back to the children of God as to what's going on. These are the announcements for all members. Let's run quickly. The advert will go through at the end of the show. Because they were giving it a bit late. Let's read the Bible.
Ndeko yanike esengeli kotika yango na system parce que tango nyonso tokobanda emission.
Brother Yannick, do please leave it on the system so that every time we have a show, it will be going through.
Genèse chapitre 13, verset 14 à 15.
Genesis chapter 13, verse 14 to 15.
Totangi na kombo na Yesu.
We read in the name of God.
Esila kilota kokabwana na Abalayama. Yahweh alobelaki Abalayama ete netola miso na yo na esika ezaliyo. Mpetala epai nebimelo na ntango pe epai ne epai na kolimwa na ntango. Verse 15. Mpoete mokili nyonso mokomona yo na kopesa yango na yo mpe na bana na yo seko.
And the Lord said unto Abraham, after Lot was separated from him, lift up your eyes and look from the place where you are, northward, southward, east and west. For all the land which you see, I will give to you and your seed forever. Let's pray for today's word. Father of glory,
Dieu d'Abraham,
God of Abraham,
Dieu d'Israël,
God of Israel,
Zambe tobele mi liboso na kiti na bokonzi.
Father, we have come under your throne.
Tika molimo na yo akamba biso.
May your spirit guide us.
Molimo na yo alobela bato na yo.
May your spirit speak to your people.
Fungolela biso mabomba mi zambi yango ezali tomba pona milimo na biso.
Reveal to us any hidden mystery, for it is good for our souls.
May
we be a root of blessing this evening for your family.
And
take authority upon anything that does not confess your name which is in front of us. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord of Nazareth, I capture its powers and I throw it into dry places.
Amen.
Amen.
Ba mama batata bilenge bozuli bakuya kozalelongo na biso mpokwa ya lelo.
Mothers, fathers and youth have had the chance to be here with us this evening.
Kolo atindi biso tozongela ekole de la foi.
The Lord has asked of us that we go back to the school
Zambi
of faith.
Biso te toza komikamba kasi yenda zo kamba biso.
For it's not us who are guiding ourselves, but he is the one guiding
us. Soki alobi telema waloba oyo tozo ya alobi toye koyebisa.
If he says stop here, get up and say this, that's exactly what we have to
oui.
Do. I'm about to summarize exactly what we spoke about within part one so that you know where we are heading to. We spoke of three different parts. Today we are now speaking of the fourth part.
In part one, we spoke of Abraham.
And in part one, we spoke of how the Lord had called Abraham. And everything that the Lord has said to Abraham was based upon promises.
Oui.
Yes.
Hey, molimo mo santo asunga kibiso.
And the Holy Spirit helped us.
Ete tambo ndimi Yesu ozana devoir ya kolikia na bilaka ya Nzambe Parce que okoti na domaine ya ba promesse.
That when you believe in God, you have the duty to put your hope on Him because you have now entered within a domain filled with promise.
Or
in other ways, we can say, when you believe in God, you need to know that God is a God of promises. The work of the cross is based upon those, the generations after generations that will come by. They will be able to see that promise existing to them too. Yes, the Holy Spirit helped us. That a believer, you should never be rushing within your life. Because your life is only dependent upon God. And only put your hope in God.
Deuxième partie.
Second part.
Tolobelaki difficulté o Abraham akutanaki na yango to nzala ya Abraham.
We spoke upon the difficulties that Abraham had gone through, or in other words, Abraham's hunger.
E na nzala ya Abraham.
And through Abraham's hunger.
Kola sungaki biso ete tango ndimi Yesu okoki kokutana na ba problem.
The Lord helped us understand that when you believe in God, you are due to go through a lot of temptations.
Okoki kokutana na ba promesi ya Nzambe.
You will go through and meet the promises of the Lord.
Kobangelo kote na ba difficulté nyonso kokutana na yango Nzambe azana control.
And you should not fear all difficulties that you may go through because God is in control.
Malgré ba difficulté kokutana na yango.
Despite the difficulties that you will go through.
Ozana devoir moko ya kote likia kake pa ina Nzambe.
You only have the duty to put your hope in God.
Troisième partie.
The third part.
Nzambe alobela kibiso likolo ya kokabwana ya Lot na Abraham.
The Lord spoke to us upon the separation of Lot and Abraham.
Na kokabwana ya Lot na Abraham.
And through their separation,
tozwaki leso monene oyo Abraham aevitaki kokweya na lisumu ya nkanda to ya koina.
We learned a great lesson in which allowed Abraham to escape from the sin of anger or hatred.
Abraham ayekolaki lolenge nini akoki kokabwana na Lot na kimya nyonso.
And Abraham had learned a way in which he could now separate with Lot in a very peaceful way. The Holy Spirit helped us reveal to the children of God that Lot was not a curse for Abraham.
No.
Lot
azalaka moyenge beni.
He was a righteous man. Because he believed in the God of Abraham. And because of his righteousness, that's how he was saved in Sodom and Gomorrah. This is exactly what we spoke of within the three different parts. But we said before we continue the pathway in which we are
in,
we need to speak upon the words in which the Lord had actually said to
Abraham.
Because after Abraham separating with Lot, the Lord had spoken to
Abraham.
But the words that the Lord had said to Abraham, it had nothing to do with saying that Lot was now a curse. Many people have said that as soon as Lot and Abraham had separated, that was when Abraham was blessed.
No. Abraham apambola makobanda mokolo Nzambe abengayi.
Abraham was blessed from the day that the Lord had called him.
Tikana balola yangu.
Let me say it in a different way.
Tango kako ndimi Yesu lokola mokonzi pe mobiki.
As soon as you believe in God as your Lord and Savior,
mokobanda mokolo wana,
from that day onwards, your life is blessed.
Exactement.
Yes.
Yangonde eloko ezalaki important.
That's what was important.
Me
But the Lord wants us to further on our thoughts. The words that the Lord had said to Abraham. The first thing. The presence of Lot was not a curse. You must know this down
carefully.
Lot's presence did not let the Lord not speak to Abraham.
No.
But the big issue was. When the Lord was speaking to Abraham, Abraham was never poor. He was already wealthy. So in other ways we can say, when you believe in God as your Lord and Savior, whether it's a witch or the demon or Satan himself, they have no power in stopping the blessings of the Lord from reaching
you.
What the Lord has planned to do for you, he will do it. Because we need to know that the Lord does not fear anything. Satan is the one that fears God. Because say God is not just a creation, but he is the creator himself. Therefore, all the words that the Lord may say or speak of, all creations on this earth must submit themselves under
it.
Abraham and Lot were both wealthy. If you read the Bible, they were even telling us about the wealth of Abraham. They said Abraham, he had gold. He had cows. He even had money. The reality is that he was fine. But we needed to pay attention to the words in which the Lord has said to Abraham. I always say to the children of God, the Bible is the word of God. It's not a newspaper. For you to know the depth of the word of God, you need to have the Holy Spirit. No theory will give you the depth of the word of God. Only the Holy Spirit.
Because
he is the only one that knows the depth of God. When Lot was with Abraham, the Lord will speak to him. Oui,
publicité wana tokotia yango na suka parce que zo mona 6 minutes.
We will put the advert towards the end because it is quite long. God bless you, Brother Yannick. Let's do it at the end because otherwise it will take up a lot of
minutes.
Because it's explaining exactly where the hall is. The Lord wants us to cultivate today's word. The Lord wants you to know
one.
When you believe in
it,
no matter who is nearby you and their sins, it will not stop the Lord from doing you good.
Yes.
Let's run quickly where we're
going.
Time is running.
The
Lord said to Abraham, when Lot had left Abraham and went away, the Lord met with
Abraham.
He said, Abraham,
Tombola miso na yo.
Raise your eyes.
Ifo ko landa bien parole ya nzambe.
You must follow carefully the words
of
God.
Ifo bien suivre la parole.
You need to follow the word of God.
Parce que soko tire attention à parole.
Because if you don't pay attention to the word,
eza difficile o comprendre lo konini nzambe alingi.
It is difficult for you to understand exactly what God's in.
Nzambe alobi na Abraham.
The Lord said to Abraham.
Alobi Abraham.
He said, Abraham.
Tombola miso na yo.
Lift your eyes.
Tonetola miso na yo.
Or lift, raise your eyes.
Netola.
Raise your eyes.
Balobaka na moto tombola miso tonetola miso kaka moto ya zelongina.
They will only tell a person to lift their eyes if they are looking down.
Ndenge na zelongina.
The way I'm looking down.
Soki dikambweza liboso na.
If there is a problem in front of me.
Mwana na ngasara koloba na ngalo bi papa tombola miso na yo tale loko nini zali.
My daughter Sarah will then tell me, Father, okay, lift your eyes to see what's coming ahead. In other ways, we can
say.
It means Abraham. His head, he was looking down. Yes. This is why the Lord has said, lift your eyes. Other people are asking themselves. Was Abraham actually sitting with his face down? Yes. We will explain this. If we read the word of God to Abraham, he said, lift your eyes up and look at from where you are sitting. Look at your left. Look at your right. Look above you. Verse 15, he said,
alobi mpomo kilinyonso yo okomona na miso na yo na kopesa yango yo pe na bana na yo libera.
For everything that you will see with your, all the land that you will see with your eyes is given to you and your further on generation.
Soki to tire attention.
When we pay attention.
Likambo oyo mo clé oyo eza important d'abord il faut to simba yango eza koneto la miso.
The key word that we must first hold on to is lift your eyes.
Koneto la miso.
Lifting your eyes. That's what's important. I did start by telling you that you need to know that Abraham was
bold.
He lacked nothing. Abraham had it all. When the Lord had met with him, he did not use the same words that he used the first day that he actually met with
him.
He said, leave. I will show you that was the beginning. But when we actually went in deep, the Lord said, lift your eyes from where you are. Look left, look right, and look in front of you. All the land that your eyes may see, I will give to you. The Lord has actually revealed to
us.
You need to know that everything that the Lord says is a whole revelation. In Joshua, he said, everywhere that your feet may stand upon is given. But to Abraham, he said, everything that your eyes shall see, I will give to you.
Quelle grâce!
What grace! It means everything that I see if my heart desires that the Lord will surely give to me. But that's not what we are speaking about today. But I simply want you to kind of open up your
soul
to understand exactly what the Lord wants to say. The key word was to lift your eyes. That's the key word. Lift your eyes. No, do not look down. Remove your eyes from looking down. But lift your eyes to see. When whatever you see is what will be given to you. Is what will be given to you. In other ways, this means if your eyes are on the ground, you are not able to see what is ahead of you, Abraham. If we further on our thoughts, We'll understand that when the Lord was speaking to Abraham, he was blessed. Abraham lacked nothing. What exactly does the Lord want to say to
Abraham?
The Lord wanted to teach Abraham something which would be very beneficial to us today. That all those that have faith, they do not live according to what they can see. Faith lives upon the promises of God. Faith is a gift which only attaches itself to the power of God. A person of faith, I want to say it like this. A person of faith will continue to put their hope in God. A person of faith, they continue to put their hope in God. The Lord wanted to say this to Abraham. He said, Abraham, no matter what wealth that I have given to you within your hand, do not put your eyes upon the things that you have. What I have given to you is small, but the ones in which I am promising you is much more than what you already have. Raise your eyes. Stop looking at the gold. Stop looking at the diamond. Stop looking at the cow. Stop looking at those servants. Lift your eyes. Stop looking at the money that you have in the bank. Remove your hope from money. Remove your hope from gold. Remove your hope upon the servants. Your family is much greater than the ones that you have right there with you. Let me say it within the period of time. I'll take a simple example. There are people that wanted to come to Europe. In Europe, they were praying. In Africa, they were praying, sorry. In Africa, they were fasting. In Africa, no one day had they missed church on a Sunday. Then, they had hope in the world. The Lord allowed them to travel and they came to Europe. They had a free house. They had free money. They were studying for free. People of God. A person then moved their thoughts away from the promises that the Lord had promised. They saw that, right, my life is already better. And at the end of all, you realize that even church did no longer attend. But what you have received is nothing compared to what the Lord has promised you. What you have received, your descendants will not be able to rejoice in it. Because first of all, it's not even enough for your own needs. Raise your eyes. Continue walking with God. Continue fearing God. Continue walking in the ways of God. Continue putting your hope in God. And what the Lord will give to you, you will enjoy it, and so will your descendants. What you have received is little. He said, hey, look to your left. Whatever you will see, I will give to
you.
But within that whole land, there was so many more wealth, much more than what he had at hand. What was left within my hand is yours. It's much more than what you have.
Pastor Evangelist.
Pastor Evangelist. This word is concerning
you.
Today the Lord has given you a church filled with 300 people. Instead of you actually lifting your eyes to see what the Lord has planned to do, you see that you're already enough. You've given yourself a throne of authority. No. But you are seeing their little. Raise your eyes. If you lift your eyes, you will then see the millions of people which are ahead of you coming towards. And if you lift your eyes, if you see it, the Lord will send all those millions of people to your feet. Yes. The church you have is small. There is no point of you even being proud. It's not for my glory. It's not for your glory either. Those that are coming where we are, they're little. Lift your eyes. If you look left, you look right, those are in China. There are people in Africa. There are people in Europe. There are people in France.
Suck your money, bango.
If you see,
suck your money, bango.
If you see, I will give you those. They will come to you. One thing which is important, you must now lift your eyes. Move your eyes away from the offering
box.
There is a much greater plate in front of you. If you lift your eyes, you see that, the ones that I have is much little compared to the ones that I see coming ahead of me. The Lord said to Abraham, you need to read carefully the word of the Lord to Abraham. Lift your eyes. To lift his eyes where? We don't know. To lift his eyes to go where? He said, look at the four corners of this world. Whatever you see, I will give to you. The issue is one is that what you have seen is exactly what I will give you. If you don't see anything, I won't give you anything. In other ways, I will explain. If within your own heart, if you believe that the ones that you have, the things, the wealth that you have right now, comparing it to the things that are to come in the future, and you believe that that is much greater, that's exactly what the Lord will do. If you believe, if you believe, listen to me carefully. If you believe that I believe that this church is not small. I see people coming. Because you believe what you believe is exactly what you believe, people will actually come. But if you just concentrate yourself there, a believer leaves, you get angry. A believer goes elsewhere, you get angry. You'll be left with nothing. You see that all believers will finish from the church. Because you do not want to lift your eyes. Let me give an example. Someone was once praying to God, I want to get married. God, I want to get married. God, give me marriage. The Lord blessed them with marriage. After the Lord blessing them with marriage, that's the even church that don't intend. That's all Lord said, lift your eyes. In marriage, there are needs. It doesn't mean just because you're married, okay, that's it, everything is done. You're in need of children. You're in need of money to take care of those children. You will have needs. need money in order to help you. You will want to prosper within your life. And for you to do so, you must lift your eyes and look ahead of you and say that, Lord, I believe you will bless. The Lord wanted to say to Abraham, what you have received is little. Lift your eyes. That whole world I will give to you and your descendants. Let me say it in a different way. The Lord wants to say to Abraham, even if you're not alive, even if you're not alive, your children, they will continue to rejoice in that wealth, although you are no longer living. But if you put your hope within the gold and the diamonds that you have, when it will finish, your children will not be able to actually enjoy it within you as a father. You need to be in possession of this wealth in order for your descendants to inherit your
heritage,
that the inheritance will come from you. Because you are the father of faith. In other ways, I can say, a person of faith, no matter what the Lord will put within your hands, they always praise God. But their hope is that whatever is ahead is much greater than what they can see.
École de la foi.
The school of faith. The Lord wanted to teach
him
for our goodness today. You're following us. After you getting a job, you've forgotten God. Your head is now upon the job. Your heart is just on the job. Even a Sunday you no longer attend church. It's good to work. But lift your eyes, because the goodness that is ahead is much more than the salary that you're receiving. In other ways, I can say, a person of faith, their hope never finishes. A person of faith, they will continue to put their hope in the greater things which is in the hands of God. Let me say, a person of faith, never do they limit their life.
No.
No. A person of faith, they see always great things. And what you see and believe is exactly what will occur within you. Because the world of faith, it does not work with just seeing. The world of faith is things that cannot be seen. Don't live by the things that you can see. You have the duty to put your hope in the things that cannot be seen in order for you to see it. The Lord said to Abraham, everything that you will see, if you see it, I will give to you. For you to receive it, you need to lift your eyes. Move away from putting your hope upon the little things. Look, today when someone is blessed, they have a house, they have a car, they have around 100,000 in their account, 500,000. They see that the whole world is upon their heads. A person becomes proud. They become proud. It's not
normal.
Whereas what you have is little.
Abraham,
lift your eyes. If you want to become great, if you want to receive all of this
world,
with its gold and its diamonds and its gold, you have the duty to raise your eyes and look ahead of you. Man of God, servant of God, where are you? You're concentrated on what? With the offerings. Those offerings are little bit. It's nothing.
No.
Lift your eyes. Look at the wealth which is within the hands of God. It's infinite. You'll understand that your heart will have peace. The Lord is in need. He said,
Abraham,
I am telling you, what I have planned to do for you is way above your own thoughts. If you think that your wealth, that is enough, I want to inform you that your wealth has not yet arrived. The Lord has told me to tell a child of Abraham, your wealth has not yet arrived. What you have is small. Raise your eyes.
Continue
to put your hope. Continue putting your hope. Continue walking in faith.
Continue walking in faith.
Continue looking up to God. Put your hope in
God.
Do not stop working. Lift your eyes. Tell the Lord. Okay, I know you've given me a hope. You've already given me marriage. You've already given me children. But I believe that you have much more wealth than what I already have. What you believe, what you see, is exactly what the Lord will give to you. If you don't see, the Lord will not give. In other ways, that means what you believe, that the Lord is capable of doing, that's exactly what the Lord will fulfill. What you don't do, the Lord will not do.
No.
École de la foi. The school of faith.
École de la foi.
The school of faith. The Lord said, lift your eyes. When Abraham had separated from Lot, the word of God, he said what?
Lot has a malédiction.
Did it say that Lot is a curse? No, it has nothing to do with that. No.
Pastor Abraham,
because Abraham, with Lot, their wealth was the one that was around. We already wealthy.
Oh, friends and sisters.
Brothers and sisters. Learn how to know your God. Learn how to walk. When you're walking, when you believe in
God,
the Lord will bless you. Thank Him for what He has already done. And then continue putting your hope in the things, the great things that are to come. You don't know what the Lord has
promised.
How can you just leave? Why is it because of small jobs that you have? Because you're now married. Because you have kids. Because you're in Europe. You now have a home to sleep in. Does that mean pain is over? I'm asking. Is that even enough for your own needs? No. It's not even enough. But for you to receive what will be enough. Well, your children will be able to eat and leave it for your descendants. You must learn how to lift your eyes in front of God. See God. A person of faith. They don't fear anything. Neither do they regret. They do not stress about it. They know that their father has
Abraham.
The Lord is defending
him. Abraham.
You said Abraham. I'm trying. I am God. You're rejoicing with what you have. You think that that's the end of it. That's not the end of it. Lift your eyes. That world, I will give to you and your children forever.
Oh, friends, they say.
Brothers and sisters, have hope in God. Have hope in God. If you put your eyes upon the things of this world, you will move out of the
problem.
Servant of God. Even if God's blessed
you,
put your eyes upon the things. If you put your eyes upon the materialistic, your gift will disappear. You don't know Satan. Satan speaks. He will just tell you, okay, just make a business. Time to preach, okay, leave someone. You go to Dubai. You go here. You're forgetting that the time in which you're traveling, the gift of God is disappearing slowly. When you will come back, you'll see that those are left in church, they are actually on fire. And then you get angry at them. Why are you getting angry? Lift your eyes. Lift your eyes. So that you concentrate on the things to come. Children of God. Your wealth. You are blessed by God. If you do not know, let me tell you. Raise your eyes. The goodness of God is in front of you. What's in front of you? Your children will rejoice. Your grandchildren will rejoice. Your great-grandchildren will rejoice from it. And they will leave it.
Oh, friends and sisters.
Brothers and sisters, the Lord is telling
Abraham,
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 Abraham, Abraham, lift your eyes, lift your eyes, lift your eyes,
Abraham,
move your eyes, move your eyes from what you can see. There is much greater things ahead, which will surprise
you.
A lot of people have now left their blessing on the way because of this. The Lord has given them a small blessing, and they think it's already above their head. They have a car,
Mercedes,
a Mercedes. They see that they're way above everyone else. Whereas that is nothing. That is nothing. What the Lord is asking of us today. You need to know. The word of God to Abraham was not that Lot was a curse. No.
No, no.
Not at all. The word of God does not say that. You need to read word by word, but exactly how the Lord said it. He said, lift your eyes. He said, oh, because Lot was a curse, okay, now I can bless you.
No.
No. But what the Lord is saying, he said it to Abraham. I will bless you. I will show you. The whole world is
here.
I will bless you. It's the same repetition. But the only thing the Lord has had is that he should lift his eyes. Not to concentrate on the things that he can see. Praise. Give me
things.
But continue putting your hope on the great things. A person of faith does not see the little issues. I am wealthy. Me. I am wealthy. I don't need to see it. But because I believe it, that's enough for me.
Oh, friends and sisters.
Brothers and sisters. Today we end. We go back to the school of faith. Now I'm telling everyone. May God bless you. May God bless the Resurrection Ministry. May the Lord bless Club Friends of Jesus. May God bless you, Evangelist. May God bless our brother Yannick. May the Lord bless all those that were space. If the Lord does not return, we'll meet on Friday. Others will meet again on Monday. On Monday, we will speak upon the battles in which Abraham went to fight for Lot. Club Friends of Jesus. 5 a.m. we start. Brother Yannick, please put up the advert of the hall. God bless you.
Merci, bye.
Thank you, bye.
Donc, au temps, malembe, ça juste 1 minute 34. bandeko libota na nzambe toye lelo pona ko kotali sabino esika wapi kolo apesi biso na ngolu na ye esika pito zo sangana biso za bongo ministère ya résurrection epai wapi na ngolu na nzambe kolo atie mosako liboyanga ayeba kokamba libota na ye awa toza bongo na Seven Sisters Station pona ba oyo bauti na kouta Stanford Hill toza bongo na Seven Sisters Station tozo mona babisi na biso nyonso ezo kende tout trois ti na police high road police station ko uta Stanford Hill lokola mutazo kende Edmonton babisi nyonso yo ezo kende a babiso bozo mona ndeko Richard ati na kamna na television donc ko kende ko koma juste na high road station donc soko za na bis okokita na stop ya high road station après wana otali okomona na police station ezo lokola na ngambo na ya droite. Mais yo garde toujours gauche na yo au pousani juste koleka police station ya high road au koti na balabala juste balabala ezana na gauche na yo donc au koti wana église eza place wana donc police station high road ezala na droite na yo soko uti na Stanford Hill ozo kende na Edmonton ba pona bato ba ko uta lokola West Green Road. Donc au Kozabis ou comme même yoti na baba la munene na high road et ba normalement faut au à gauche tozi ba biso ezo kende Edmonton au komi na fe o ya munene place ba biso ki na ko Tottenham Hill mais yo ko continuer ti na Tottenham High Road police station à partir à High Road police station soko tali ko mona yango ezala toujours na loboko na ya mobali alors au soko pousani moke au leki kaka police station ne au romona baba la liboso na gauche donc justement tant on a 7 6 tant au leka tesko ezana droite na yo au leki au comité na fe au leki donc ezalo kwa stop o landi na stop o ya police station High Road police station donc one des références na biso to longo na 7 6 to kie suko yo ne na lobaki tout à l'heure lokola mutu batwa ke ned Edmonton to komi awa bozo mona na ngambu mosusu ezali na High Road police station na ngambu mosusu me yo tiki na ngambu oyo ya bis ya mupanzi kote tozali bongo na koleka yango omona ba bis lokola ba 149 ba 279 ba bis ezo kende Edmonton Green allez soko le kimuke police station ne na lobaki wana. Donc baba la oyo elandi na gauche na yo baba lango komo lango Foster Road po koleka ba police station omona ba shop ezawana ndeti ya munene omona Enfield Food Center eza pepe mbeni wana okomona ba shop eza vraiment ebele mususu batielo kwa signe moko munene ya McDonald's na likolo wana donc wana eza na loboko ya police station mais yo siko ozala na gauche omona ba bus lokwa ba 243 ezo ke na Edmonton donc okozanga ngo vraiment eza vraiment clair après que la police station est au bas au côté à gauche donc ce qu'on a bis au côté à stop déco pour un bateau et au bas au yana bis donc référence à biso et zaka stop au ya police station ya high road alors ce qu'on a la voiture ce qu'on comme la police station ya high road au continuer aux yaka malembe au roman à balabala Foster Road et zawana au roman à panneau moko et zawana bakoma adis Edmonton North, au mona panneau vert, on a des akana balabala wana. Au mona pe maison moka funeral les awana. Maison funeral les awana bakuma funeral directors. Yeah. Au mona ngwana zana Foster Road. Donc référence vraiment monene ngwana. Donc ceux qui oyena bis au kiti na stop ya High Road police station. Donc autant bolika malem beza juste 1 minute 34 secondes. Donc il na meki autant ngon vraiment après bandeko oyo nyoso ba uti Edmonton bazaka bakota ba Enfield bokoza ba bis nyoso ezo kende Stanford Hill to o bis nyoso ko le candela ya Seven Sisters. Donc référence na biso à partir wana sokozo ya o leki station ya Bruce Grove o leki McDonald's o komi juste na Halifax banque ya Halifax eza wana eza pembeni ya maison oyo ya Bet eza William Hill donc eza juste droite na bino na gauche na yo omona maison moko ya pizza gogo za wana na Enfield Food Center aluzi droite na yo pona bato ba uti ko uta Edmonton Green ko kenena na okene na Stanford Hill. Donc soko komi wana komi juste na Halifax, Halifax au mona William Hill, ozui droite na yo mbala moko eza Foster's Road. Ko soki okoti na Foster's Road, okomona balabala au mona signe lokola ya one way juste kaka na gauche na yo. Donc soko koti au mona deja pano munene ba komi bongo Christ the King Dominion Place. Donc ko soko koti na Foster's Road, au côté de Foster Road, au Poussanika, il y a à peu près 100 mètres. Bon, au moment na na lobo qu'on a à gauche, au moment où on a signé à Mounene, il y a Christ the King Dominion Place. Donc, on a des places au ministère de la résurrection, place où tu vas nous sanguiner chaque dimanche. Donc, à partir de Foster Road, sur le côté déjà, na gauche, donc au Rosang, au côté au moment déjà pendant mon année, ils a juste na déco. Donc, bateau bauti kouta Stanford Hill, bauti Seven Sisters, ko kende na Edmonton. Donc, après police station, au côté na première gauche, na ils a Foster Road. Bah, bauti Edmonton, bah ko kende na Seven Sisters, bah au soir droite après juste après Halifax. Donc ce soko au droite baba long Foster Road au côté na kato tambola à peu près c'est à peu près 100 mètres de au monde na gauche na yo église à monene za wanda comme monene za wana ba comme Christ the King Dominion Place. Donc ils a juste on na kwa na gauche. Donc to ko zanga ngote wana za isika oyo nzamba pesibiso pour to continuer toujours ko sa musala nai. Merci.